Hello everyone, welcome to MES e-learning channel. We at Pillai HOC College of Engineering and Technology Rasayani committed to provide the awareness about energy consumption and energy saving to the society. At a first step, we will going to calculate energy consumption at our home. For that, I have taken some of the sample loads like tube light, fan, fridge, AC, laptop, etc. Let us start the session. Now, we consider tube light. For the tube light, the constant power, that is a constant power, would be 36 watt. It is a normal one. Suppose if you are using LED or CFL, that may be 9 watt or 12 watt or 15 watt or 20 watt, etc. You can ask me the question, sir, how can I find the power rating of any appliances? I will show you an example. Here, I have taken a sample data sheet or appliances nameplate like Samsung TV 32 inch, it consumes 54 watt. So, each and every appliances will be having this data. You can find it through user manual or website or power rating nameplate of the appliances. Next, we take for the fan. The fan what we are using will be consuming 60 to 70 watt. I take as 70 watt. Then fridge around 200 watt. I am talking about 160 to 180 liter fridge. It is 200. Then go for AC. When talk about the AC, we have to consider EER, energy efficiency ratio. So the power consumption of AC, it would be cooling capacity upon EER, that is energy efficiency ratio. This is already we have the constant number which have been calculated, 3516 upon 3.17. It's around 1100 watt. So, I have taken 3.17 for singleton AC 5 star. If you take 3 star or 4 star, the number will go down. So, automatically the energy consumption will be high. So, as a constant value, I have taken here 1000 watt. For approximately, I have taken 1000 watt. Then laptop, each and every laptop consuming 50 watt. And TV, I'll take as a 45 inch TV, it would be 70 watt for higher end. Then geyser is consuming more energy. So, the power would be 1000. This is a standard one. It may be 1500 to 2000, depends upon your household appliances. Then mixy, we take as a 400. Once again, this is a standard value. Then washing machine, the latest washing machine consuming 500 watts. So, I take as 500. Then microwave oven. When I talk about the microwave oven, it operates three modes. One is grill mode, oven mode and convection mode. The convection mode consumes more power. So, now take an average value of 1500. Is it clear? So, these are the loads connected to the home. And we talk about the numbers. Say example, I take for tube light 4 numbers, then fan 4 numbers, fridge 1, AC 1, laptop 1, TV 1, geyser 1, mixy 1, washing machine 1, microwave oven 1. So, it may vary. Suppose if you are using 2 AC, just put it here 2, that's all. Then total watts, how many total watts consumed or absorbed by the tube light? 36 into 4, number of units into watts per unit. So it will be around 144, and this is 280, and this is 200, this would be 1000, this would be 50, this would be 70, this is 1000, just I'm multiplying, this is 400, this is 500, and this is 1500. So this is the total power absorbed by the appliances. It would be 5144 watts. 5144 watts. Watt is unit of power. Then number of hours. I consider I am using tube light for 5 hours in my home. Then fan I consider as 10 hours in my home. Then fridge. Fridge I use 24 hours. But the duty cycle of fridge is 30%. It means that out of 24 hours, only 8 hours the compressor will run. So I take as a 8 hours. Then AC, I consider as a 5 hours, I am using AC per day. And laptop, 2 hours. TV, 2 hours. Then geyser, consider 1 hour. Mixie, I am using half an hour, 30 minutes. Washing machine, consider I am using 1 hour, and microwave oven I am using half an hour. This is, once again, it will vary, depends upon the user. So right now we have calculated the total power of each and every appliances as well as the total power which is absorbed in our home. Now we calculate the energy consumption. Energy means power into time. So this is a power multiplied by time. It is around 720, and this is 2800, multiply this 1600, now multiply this is 5000, this is 100, and this is 140, and this would be 1000, and this is 400 into half an hour, it is 200. And this is 500, and this is 7750. Okay. The total energy consumed per day at this load is 12810 watt hour, because we multiplied power into time. We have calculated energy consumption per day, but we have to calculate for 30 days. So it would be 12810 into 30. It is around 38430 watt hours. Finally, 384.30 kilowatt hour. This is what important here. This is unit, kilowatt hour is a unit. So the total units will be 384.3. So we are paying the electricity bill for not the power consumption, we are paying the electricity bill for energy consumption, that is units. The total energy consumed by the particular user is 384.3 units. Now I am going to tell how to calculate the price or amount for the particular units what we have used. I have taken the sample load from a user. You can see the fourth circle, it is 225 units. That is how we have to read the energy consumption of our home. Here it is given the table below, it is clearly given that 0 to 100 units 3 rupees, 101 to 300 units it is 6.73 rupees, 301 to 500 it is 9.75 rupees. So right now we are going to calculate the amount for the energy consumption happen at our home. So the calculated energy consumption at for the particular load is 384.3 units. As per the given data, it is 0 to 100 units 3 rupees, 3 to 100 it is 300. Then 101 to 300 units it is 6.73 into 200. It would be 1346. Then 301 to 500 it is 9.75 into 84 units. Okay, so it would be 819. The total amount would be 2465 rupees. Apart from this, there is a constant charges by the each and every service provider. For MSEB, the constant charge is 80 rupees plus GST, what other things, etc. So this is how we have to calculate the energy consumption as well as the total amount for the electricity. So I repeat, we are paying not for the power, we are paying electricity bill for the energy consumption at our home. In terms of, we say, units. I would like to inform one thing. When you connected a charger to the socket, but you don't use the mobile to charge, the charger will consume 0.5 units. So, I repeat, don't waste energy. Thank you.